Hello, welcome to Sandy Ainley. I hope each one of you are well. I've been up since about 3:15 a.m. and it is now 20 to 8 in the morning. And I've been really happy. I've been watching YouTube. I watched quite a bit on subject of Paul O'Grady, the late Paul O'Grady, sadly. And I've been watching Annie Warbucks, which was a real flop, very sadly. I think it was a good musical, although I don't think it was as powerful as Annie. I don't mind comparing. The first show, the first Annie show, I think was far better, I don't mind saying. I continue to believe that Annie Warbucks could have made it quite big had the casting possibly been more powerful, definitely if the casting was more powerful. It's possible that Annie Warbucks would have made it quite big, so to speak. However, it didn't seem to be the case, and so it wasn't to be, so to speak. And then I've been watching, what else? I'm trying to think. What else did I watch on YouTube? Oh, I watched a bit of a film via Netflix on subject of a little boy who got a part in a play or a film in, I think, Hollywood, and was raped, and then came back to his home, so to speak. And when his family found out that he was raped, the family tried to report the rapist, and everybody in concern was in denial, and they tried to turn the law against the family and the little boy. It was all very weakly performed, in my opinion, so I didn't watch it to the end. At the beginning, I thought, oh, lovely, this is going to be a really good film, and I really enjoyed the first part. But then as it slowly went on and on, I gradually got to feel that it was quite weakly performed, in my opinion of weakly performed. I mean, I'm not an experienced critique when it comes to film analysing. I'm better with theatre analysing, I don't mind saying. Ever since a child, I had a deep feeling for comparing and judging performers, particularly children actresses and singer and singers and dancer and dancers. I feel and think that my talent lies more with children than with adults, as in analysing, as in judging them. I used to sit down and play, gosh, a little girl, Shirley Temple, and I used to think to myself, would Shirley have been a good Annie? And I watched more than one of Shirley's films. I bought a whole set of Shirley's film selection, and I analysed Shirley Temple's performing, and I decided that dance-wise, Shirley could definitely have played Annie. Voice-wise, Shirley could have played Annie. However, I don't mind saying the voice would have been not in my opinion, a powerful Annie singer. However, that's just in my opinion. obviously the little girl made it very big, so to speak, in show business. So one might argue that my opinion is incorrect, though sometimes a person makes it very big in show business doesn't always necessarily follow that it's the talent in that one, in this case, singing aspect, is going to be as good as the person is well liked and famous. There could be other reasons, of course, couldn't there, as to why one makes it big in show business, so to speak. Could be the personality, could be the acting, could be the dancing, could be the singing, could be the staging, the charisma, personality, character, hobbies, preferences, sexual preferences, one's personality, one's attitude, you know. So it's the whole picture, so to speak. And Shirley, for me, didn't have it with the singing so much. But, I mean, for a little child, she wasn't bad at singing either. I'm not saying I'm God's expert to analysing child performing. However, I'm certainly more expert than I am at analysing adult performing. It's something that's very deep inside of me. And I just enjoy it. I just enjoy it. Yes, that's the best manner in which to put it to you. Going on subject of Annie Warbucks, what I felt was, and thought, was that there was a dance, I think one says sequence, and there were about 20 children on the stage, and each wearing the same style dress, however a different colouring in each little girl. And it was the standard, if you remember, the red Annie dress, red with the white belt and the white collar, I think it had. And it was the older, much young, you know, the older, the young, sorry, I started again on that bit, the older version of Annie, when there was that red and white dress at the end of the show of Annie. Well, that's what, probably the little Annie was wearing the red one, and then each child was wearing exactly that dress, however, yellow and white, blue and white, green and white, mauve and white. And when I said and white, I meant wearing the belt in white and the collar in white. And the dancing on the stage was mainly tap, I think, tap dancing. And I just thought that the stage didn't look tidy to me. Be that was as a result of the casting perhaps not being so powerful, or maybe it was just the idea, the direction, the style of dancing. Maybe a mixture, maybe neither. But I mean, just from my opinion, the stage and the performing just didn't seem to do it for me too much, though at the same time it was okay. That's just my view, one person's view, and my view, and I appreciate my view just as I welcome your view. If you so wish to check up on it, it's called Annie Warbucks again, and Annie Warbucks you'll find on YouTube. There's a little girl who played Annie, who was Catherine Zaremba or some name to that effect. And It's Zaremba, I think, yes. For example, I was listening to Lena Zavaroni, if you recall, that young lady who very sadly is no longer with us. The lady had problems with her mental health, and very sadly, I think, forgive me if I'm incorrect, please, I think the lady committed suicide, but I could be wrong, so don't quote me on it, please. Although I'm quoting myself on it because I'm on national, international viewing. So forgive me if I'm incorrect, please. I know for sure that the lady very sadly had a lot of problems and passed away very young. And I listened very deeply to Lena and Singing Tomorrow. And I thought to myself, could Lena have played Annie? And the answer is yes. However, again, there was something, I think it's probably connected to the sadness in Lena's life. There was a sadness and a kind of a death to Lena on stage. There was too much sadness in that lady, in my opinion, for performing a role like Annie, which ends up very happy and Annie being very on top of the world, so to speak. So yes, that's the manner which I look at it, that Lena, that's my view. And I also heard there's a young girl called Claire Crosby, I think's the surname. Little girl who has her father. They sing on YouTube together. A little Claire Crosby, I think's the name, as I said. Yes, a talent and very small and young. And the father's brilliant and the mother. They're both musicians. And I think now one of their other daughters is starting to sing as well, quite nicely. Or as it might be their son, or both, maybe. And I think there's another child on the scene now. So I think altogether there's about 1, 2, 3, 4 children, I think. And the parents are just amazing. They encourage, I mean, for example, Claire, so much. They go all over the world, I think, promoting Claire. And they've got a lot of subscribers. They've got well over 1 million, I think. Forgive me if I'm incorrect, please. Possibly more on the lines of 2 or 3 million, if I'm not mistaken. They really have done extremely well. And forgive me if I'm incorrect, please, but certainly a lot of subscribers. And they deserve it, in my opinion, of deserving it. So good on you if you're listening, Claire. And keep it up, please, because you're good. Do I think Claire could play Annie? I think Claire's voice would need to be very much pushed for a role like Annie, which needs to be. Annie's a tough little girl in the show who couldn't survive on the streets. And Claire is a sweet little girl who is tough, or seems tough. However, could Claire play the acting role as a tough little girl who would survive on the streets? The answer is I don't know. I haven't seen and or heard Claire sing enough Annie to be in a position for me to form an opinion and an analysis. Got it out this time. An analysis. So going on to Bonnie Langford. Oh my goodness, Bonnie Langford. For those of you who know who I mean, yeah, a lovely performer. Very typical lady of someone who was a child star, so to speak. Talented at singing, yes. Talented at dancing, yes. Talented at acting, yes. Could Bonnie Langford have played Annie? Yes. Definitely. She could have been quite a good Annie. Not the best, in my opinion, of the best. I don't mind comparing. However, quite a good Annie, as I said. I quite like Bonnie's overall performing. A bit child starish, cutie pie-ish, baby face-ish for me personally. However, there's no denying that the lady's a gifted person at performing and a theatrical type of lady. So I'm just giving you a bit of an analysis this morning of some performing that I've seen and heard, and sharing with you my love for the theatre. And just to bid you goodbye, I'm going to do my little sing-song that I like to do these days for you. And this time I'm going to just do my next made-up song, my next composition. How I do it, how I do it. Now you hear me, now you hear me. Oh, I never did know, I never did know, I never did know how I dream it, but now it becomes reality. Thank you very much indeed. And please take care of yourself. And please take care of one another. Lots of love. Bye-bye.